Hi, my name is Shanta Maharaj Singh. I'm a professional counselor, a coach, a neuroagility practitioner, and an acu-detox practitioner, amongst other things that I dabble in. I do all this under my business banner of successful mindset strategies. I'm often faced with different kinds of therapies, a whole multitude of them, when assisting clients. And writing has come up as a common thread with so many people. Now, we are in lockdown, and there's an assumption that there's time to do all this. So, as I said, there is an assumption. And people want to keep journals and things like that. Now, today I'm going to be chatting to someone I only knew through her English teacher. And this was very strange because in 2014, when she and I lost a common person, she wrote to me. When I read that letter, to me, it was amazing. It was as if, of course, there was sorrow. I'm not denying that. There was an element of grief in there. But there was no denial of grief. There was more a tribute to how good it was knowing the person and the impact the person had on our lives. And I looked at this and I thought, I've never met this young lady. I've known her through this common thread. And I'm gaining so much of strength from that. So looking at that, you know, it's the power of writing. And how do we use this power? So 6.5 years later, I've got her on my screen. We've kept a good relationship. I've seen her develop. I've seen her grow. I'm really proud of her. Love this dear young lady. And she's given me some time this morning to talk about writing. Writing as therapy, writing as a hobby, and what does writing do for you? I'm going to introduce you to Vuyi, and all I'm going to say is, who are you, Vuyi? Tell us.
You know, that is a very difficult question to answer. My mentor recently asked me to unpack who Vuyi is, and it's been a struggle for me doing that. And recently I discovered that it's not so much a difficulty, it's just I find that I'm constantly evolving, revolving, rediscovering who I am. And symbolically, I could say Vuyi is a phoenix. Whether it could be she's soaring, whether it could be she's falling, crashing, and burning, or it be her rising from those ashes.
Right, Vuyi. There's just so much about you that's so common with me, really. I think this is why that special link joined us in some strange way. Very, very strange way. Vuyi, you wrote me that beautiful letter. How do you feel about writing about pain and destroying it? And I'm talking about the fact that when I do journaling with some people, look, each person handles this differently, and I respect that. But I often get this, well, I've written everything, and I've burnt it. What's your comment about when you write? And you know, give me your insight.
Yeah. You know, it's interesting because just on the 3rd of January, I think I'd say I did the same. I wrote down some of my past hurts, some mistakes that I've made that I wish to never repeat. And then I burnt it. But before I did that, I had to channel my inner compass. I had to truly mentally and emotionally train my mind and heart to release the hurt, to release the pain, and to forgive myself. So my personal view is, if you're able to express something on paper, then clearly it's in mind and heart. And only once you've worked on your mind and your heart can you symbolically then burn a journal.
That's so true, because if it's still within you and you've just done this burning, all you've done is increase the carbon footprint.
True.
Because you've still got it within you. If you're still going to be speaking about it, and going on down the line, speaking about it, then that was an exercise in futility.
Yeah.
However, if you've healed, and evolved, it's different. But sadly, in most of the cases I've come across, when you're going through chatting to them about grief, about loss or death, or whatever, this bitterness still comes up. And if the bitterness still comes up, the writing hasn't done anything for you. It hasn't helped you at all. What drives you to write?
One word, emotion. Deep emotion. I could classify myself as an empath, an empath. I feel everything too much. And the amazing thing about it is the emotion just comes, it hits me at most random of times, and I start writing, I start typing, and voila, there's a piece of writing.
Wonderful.
I thought of an example of where I am currently in my life and where I've come from. Mm-hmm. And I thought of work that my mother as a single parent has done behind the scenes. And at seeing who I am today, she's just so proud. And the emotion of gratitude brings about so many words that I could just fill a page with my gratitude to her. Yeah. So it's really just emotion.
I can actually feel that in you. And you know, you mentioned that one word or one single emotion can give you a volume of words to express it.
Indeed.
So there's beauty in writing, absolute beauty in writing. Will you paint a quick picture for me in three words? Vuyi, past, present, and future.
Looking at my journey, I'd say past would be, I thought of weather. Past would be doom, gloom, and fog. Present would be skies clearing, and the future would be blue skies and a full rainbow.
You got me a bit silenced there, which is quite unusual for me to be silenced. If I looked at words being the most powerful way to express things, right? Do you think words complementing art? Are you somebody into drawing, or would you say words are far more powerful than a picture or anything of that sort? I'm looking at the therapeutic part of it as well.
Yes, I would say that. I'm not a very expressive person in verbal words, but when it comes to paper and pen, I lay it out there. I mean, if you get to know someone, especially with me, if I get to trust someone much to speak to them about the things that make me sad, what makes me happy, how I feel at present, it's different when I pour out, literally pour out my emotion on paper. And the interesting thing is, as well, I find that people don't understand me, but once I have it on paper, I find that the reader actually gets it. It's a strange phenomenon, yeah.
Yeah, it really is. Now, you speak about pouring out and the reader getting it, right? Let's go back to therapy and writing journals and burning them, etc. That burning or destroying a journal or anything that you write deprives the next person an opportunity of interpretation.
True.
Now, look at us, our setup for you. We had never even laid eyes on each other. I think you knew me through a photograph, a family photograph.
Yes.
Or some picture that was there of, you know, in the classroom.
Yeah.
And I had not known you. But you wrote to me and I understood what you wrote because I related personally to what was going on. I'm so sorry about that. Okay, let's get back to that. That was what happens at all times when a phone suddenly starts ringing and you're in the midst of a recording and you realize you haven't put your phone up. Yeah, so here we were, two strangers.
Yeah. But,
what you expressed, strange enough, was what I felt. But I wasn't in an emotional place at that time to express it like you did. And you and I have about a 30-year age gap between us. But yet there was a common thread running, two strange people having experienced a common loss.
Yeah.
And how the expression of one person helped heal the other. And when I look at it, we're going through COVID-19. How do you think people could cope with this, with writing? Do you think it could help in a way? How do you think they should relate to these journals? Should they give them to somebody to read, or should they write, read, edit, go back?
You know, a very a personal experience right now. We might not be able to express how we feel to others.
Mm-hmm.
And writing does help. Sometimes even when words don't come, but if you have to, they naturally come through. I recently wrote a poem to a, I'm going to say, anonymous person, and I did not know what to say. And even in that very poem, I do mention, I don't know what to say, but here it is. And getting it out there, it helps. Whether the person reads it, whether or not, it just helps. It's out of your system.
Okay, so it's a way of easing pain.
Yeah.
Vuyi, should we be looking out for you for a write-up, for a book, some publishing?
You know, I've thought about it quite a lot. I have a family friend who is an English professor down in PE, and I have spoken to him about looking at some of my poetry and some of my pieces. But for some reason, I've held back. I think I've felt inadequate. But I am thinking about doing it. And yeah, I've also recently started a YouTube channel. It's just got one video.
So that's how it starts, with one video. It does.
Yeah.
So we'll and this is your second one going up.
Yes, this is my second one.
So yes, there's a lot going up.
Yeah.
What type of writing would you be having in your book? Would it be poetry? Would it be stories? Would it be motivational writing?
Yes, I've got quite a few collections of short pieces, poems of inspiration, of love, of grief, of my life experiences. So it's anything that I've felt and have been able to put down in writing.
Okay. Parting shots for you to anyone who wants to start on this journey of expressing themselves in words. What would you say?
Just do it. Get that pen, get that paper, get that laptop, computer. Just do it. And like I say, English is not my first language. And I have a family friend who is an English professor who would be willing to look at it and say, maybe try this. You know, there are people that are always willing to help if you just want it that much.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You know, there's a saying I came across a few days ago, and it says, if you want to become immortal, write.
Yeah.
Because in writing, you will always be remembered in some way or the other. And I think, you know, our relationship has actually immortalized somebody else that we know, the common person, the common thread. Because that person lives through you and I and a few other people, you know, like I wish we could get hold of some of the other naughty young people that we've had tea and coffee with. But absolutely, you know, attained immortality through the relationships that grew, started with writing.
True.
but grew. And to us, it's like, you know, we're just carrying on. We're just, there's just so much that's still alive.
Yeah.
And I hope and pray that people who are going through grief take a leaf out of this book that we've just shared. How, you know, your writing helped me to cope. And down the line, 6.5 years later, it still helps me to cope. It's an inspiration. And you've immortalized the memory through writing. So yes, Vuyi, delightful chatting to you. I look forward to many more chats with you. Such an interesting young lady. And yeah, be safe. And until we meet again, may you just be, you know, loved and looked after by the Almighty. Be very, very careful. We live in
dangerous times.
Thank you so much, Vuyi. Thank you for your time. Take care, my dear young lady. Bye-bye.